The coronavirus has transformed our lifestyles and it's now reshaping our cities too. More than 17 million people live in our capitals, which have been experiencing a real COVID migration boom. Greater Brisbane leads the surge, up by 1.9%, with Perth pretty close behind. Even Melbourne recorded strong growth despite its COVID ordeal. All of Queensland is booming and the state is running a national $7.5 million campaign to lure workers to tourism jobs. Social researcher Mark McCrindle is with me now to break down the stats. Mark, good morning to you. Thank you for being here. This is so fascinating. Let's look at Queensland first. I mean, regional Queensland, for example, growing faster than most of our capital cities. I was in a taxi in Queensland recently and the cabbie said they're not even putting signs up on houses now. They're selling that quick. What is going on? How rapid is this surge towards Queensland and regional Queensland?
Well, it's huge. I mean, the fact that Queensland is growing by more people than any other state or territory at the moment is new terrain, growing much faster than the larger states of New South Wales and Victoria. And this, of course, is in an era of closed borders, so there's no international migration. This is all internal migration. Pretty low birth rates as well, so it's all the shift to the north. And there's a bit of shift to the west in WA as well, but Australians are relocating.
Queensland's capital also leads city growth. Perth fared well too. What are the factors at play there?
Well, again, it's Australians just rebalancing their life now, looking at what's going to work for them, firstly from an affordability perspective. And the prices in Perth and Brisbane are a lot better than you get in Sydney and Melbourne. Secondly, you've got the lifestyle and livability. So people are saying, well, you know, I can work from anywhere now in a work-from-home environment, and that's really leading to this geographical mobility as people readjust.
Isn't it magnificent for the economies in our regions, which, of course, need all the support after a whole host of testing factors recently? Every city except Darwin had population growth. Melbourne attracted 80,000 new residents, 1.6% growth. Which states grew most in the regions?
Well, Queensland just is growing and topping the charts in every area. But regional growth across Australia is very strong, again, for those same reasons. Better affordability in the regions, great lifestyle, and, of course, you can keep your city job now and relocate to the regions or maybe just commute to that city job a couple of times a week. So it's good news for the regions that have been looking for growth. Some of our capitals have been choking with the growth and we haven't had enough infrastructure there. The regions are looking for the growth because with that comes an economic boom and investment in infrastructure. Infrastructure and housing. So, you know, they are really benefiting and it is rebalancing our population away from just capitals to see our regions flourish.
I love when we ask you to get the crystal ball out, Mark, and tell us what areas are going to boom next, who's on the move.
Well, if we look at who's moving, we've always had retirees relocate from cities to regional areas. This is young couples and young families, so there's a long period ahead for them, which is great for the economy. Also, it's mainly those in apartments, more so than detached homes, that are making the move in Australia because, well, they're looking for a bit more space. And those who have worked from home are far more likely than those who worked in the office to make this relocation, just as they recognise, well, maybe I need a new home or a different setup, and maybe the regions will offer that lifestyle.
So broadly a shift away from apartments, where, you know, broadly across Australia where possible?
Exactly, because people found in the lockdowns and they've found in a work-from-home environment that maybe the one or two better isn't quite providing the space, particularly if you've got two people working from home there. A bit more space and detached homes offer that, a bit of greenery, a bit of backyard as well.
Mark, thanks for breaking it down for us. Great to chat.
Thanks, mate.